The talented group of 83 musicians that make up the Utah Symphony are heading into their 73rd season this September. This is one of only 18 full-time orchestras left in the United States, and we're the smallest market with this distinction. The impact of the Utah Symphony is widespread. They made their mark in Europe when they did their landmark recordings of Mahler, and are the first orchestra to do so. This is one reason we caught the eye of our 7th music director, Terry Fisher. The Utah community has embraced him since his appointment in 2009. With his distinguished resume, he's appreciated for his discipline, precision, and energetic conducting style. Maestro Fisher is also committed to education and will personally conduct some of the orchestra's educational concerts for junior high and high school students. To give you an idea of the orchestra's inspiration, the Utah Symphony reaches approximately 170,000 students a year, basically reaching every school kid in Utah every 3 years. Either the symphony goes on the road, or the kids are brought in by bus to see the orchestra at Abravanel Hall. Pat Richards, president and CEO of the Utah Symphony, said watching the students experience a symphony, usually for the first time, is a sight to behold. They make sure to play relatable music, like the score from Star Wars, for example, and the kids love it. The Utah Symphony can also claim the longest-running musician in the United States, Frances Darger, who started as a young girl and retired just last year after 69 years. The orchestra's ticket sales are going strong, and the Deer Valley Music Festival is on a roll. If you haven't had a chance to hear our symphony at Deer Valley Under the Stars with your own picnic, put that on your list. Check out all the activity and the fall lineup at utahsymphony.org. For Zions Bank, I'm Chris Redgrave, speaking on business.